Welcome back. We'll continue the ethnobotanical survey conducted in the Palanpur district. The next plant is Pinus roxburghii. Common name is cheed. Belongs to family Pinaceae, and it is found in the Kandi village of Palanpur. And flowering season is April to June. And the part used is seed. The ethnobotanical or ethnomedicinal uses of this plant is eye infection and other disease also. The dry seed crushed with the almond seed, and it is applied over a cotton plug. The carbon is obtained, which is known as kajal, and this kajal is applied to the eyes of children to cure the infection. The next plant is plantago. Plantago is commonly known as isafgol. Isafgol belongs to family Plantaginaceae, and it is found in the Rodi village. Flowering season is March to August. The part uses leaves, and traditional healer use this plant for curing the skin disease and diarrhea. The leaves are crushed to make the paste of the leaves in the cow urine, and this paste is mixed with the butter and applied on the skin for improving the skin disease. The next is Plumbago gilanica. This plant is commonly known as chitrak, and if you see the history of this plant is utilized by Vedas in Ayurveda and even in homeopathy also. This belongs to the family Plumbaginaceae and found in the Badrol village of Palanpur. The flowering season is March to October, and the part used is root, stem, leaves. The traditional healer use this plant in toothache, arthritis and skin disease. What they did, they generally do the root paste and apply this on the various seed of kalimirch and used by the traditional healer. Then Bambusa, commonly known as bamboo, belongs to family Poaceae, and it is also found in the same area. The part uses leaves and young shoot. It is used by the traditional healer for curing the hematomesis and fractures and injuries. What they did, the older and dried stem of bamboo are used in splint in fracture. The next plant is Cymbopogon citratus. It is commonly known as lemongrass, belongs to family Poaceae, found in the same area, and flowering season is October to December, and part use is leaves. It is used in digestive disorder and skin disease. Generally, they boil the leaves of this plant and consume to improve the digestive system or digestive disorder. And for the skin disease, the essential oil is very effective for skin disease. The next plant is Rumex nepalensis. This is commonly known as jungli palak, and belongs to family Polygonaceae, and location is same Palanpur area. The flowering season is April to July, and leaves and roots are used by the traditional healer. Traditional healer used to cure the boils and constipation of this plant. One more thing, it is also antidote of Bechubuti. Punica granatum, it belongs to family Punicaceae, found in the same area. The flowering season is May to September, and seed and fruit are utilized by the traditional healer for curing the piles problem and indigestive problem, and even for vomiting. For vomiting, dry and fresh seeds are encrusted with the pudina and consumed by the patient to stop the vomiting. The next plant is Chilanthus. The common name is Chandan, and it is also found in the same area, but there is no flowering because this particular plant belongs to the pteridophyte. the cryptograms. The part uses whole plant, and the traditional healer use this particular plant or decoction of the whole plant for curing the various disorders like the weaknesses and other disease. The Thelictum belongs to the same area, and the flowering season is June to October, and traditional healer use the root for this particular plant for curing the boils and the toothache, even for the mouth ulcer. Principia utilis, it is belongs to the family Rosaceae, and the location is same Rodi village of the Palampur, and flowering season is in December to March, and part used by the traditional healer is leaves and the seed. The decoction of the fresh young leaves and apical bud is consumed twice in a day for curing the cough and fever, even for the this seed oil massage is used for joint pain, etc. Prunus caryoides, it's a padam, belongs to the Rosaceae, found in the same area. Flowering season is November to May, and traditional healer use the seed and bark of this particular plant for curing the internal injury and for other disease also. Then Pyrus is the common name is Kent, belongs to family Rosaceae, found in the same area. Flowering season is March to May, and traditional healer use the fruit and stem for curing the mouth ulcer and boils. They generally take the twig or burn and obtain the saps, and sap is applied for curing the boils. The common name is also Rubus and Akhe, belongs to the family Rosaceae, and found in the same area. The flowering season is March to April, and fruit and roots are utilized by the traditional healer for curing the blood purifier, or we can say the it's a very good blood purifier and the for curing the boils. Then Radia dumentorum, it is also found in the same area. The flowering season is December to February, and fresh leaves and root are utilized by the traditional healer for arthritis and for pneumonia also. The Eagle marmalis, it's very common plant. The common name is Belpatr. It is also found in this area and belongs to family Rutaceae. The flowering season is April to June. The fruit pulp, it utilized by the traditional healer for the digestive problem and dysentery also. The citrus lemon, it's a very common plant we use in the daily life. It's commonly known as nimbu. We used the nimbu for various form. We use the achar, we use the murabba, we use the direct consumption of the nimbu, and the whole plant is utilized by the traditional healer for sore throat and malaria and other fever also. Moraya koningi, it's a very common plant known as karipatta, commonly known as karipatta, and belongs to the family Rutaceae. It is also found in the same area, means the Palampur area, and flowering season is April to May, and the part used is leaves. The traditional healer use these leaves decoction for the digestive problem and for internal injury also. We generally use this karipatta in the making the sambar and idli also. Moraya paniculata, this is the another species of moraya, and the common name is Dinhar and Anghar, belongs to same family and found in the same area, and flowering season is April to May, and leaves are utilized by the traditional healer for diarrhea and for dysentery and even for other disease like the joint and internal part of the body if anybody having the some injury. The next plant is Dodonia viscosa. Dodonia viscosa is also found in the Burn village of the Palampur, and flowering season is March to May, and the fresh leaves are utilized by the traditional healer for curing the internal injuries and other disease also. The lychee sinensis, it's a common fruit, it's a lychee, belongs to family Sapindaceae, found in the Badrol village of the Palampur, and flowering season is August to October, and part use is fruit, seed, root, bark. All these parts are utilized by the traditional healer for throat ailment. The decoction of the root, bark, flowers are used as the gargle to improve the throat infection. Even the fruit peel is used in the treatment of diarrhea. The verbascum thapsus. This is the another plant found in the same area. The flowering season is March to September. The part used by the traditional healer is leaves, root and seed for curing the piles. The dry root and the grounded to the water and roasted in the ghee. It is also used to cure the respiratory problem by the traditional healer. Even it is, the seeds are burnt on the red charcoal and it used by the traditional healer for improvement in the chicken pox. Then Brugmansia is commonly known in the particular area is Dhatura, belongs to family Solanaceae, and the flowering season is September to November, and the part uses flower and leaves. It is used to cure the achic and the pain and even wound rashes and ulcers by the traditional healer. The leaves paste is applied externally on the wound area to improve the or to fill the wound also. The capsicum annuum, it is the very very common. We generally use the hari mirch in daily life, in the daily in the house, and belongs to the family Solanaceae, and it is also found in the same area. The flowering season is July to September. The fruit and the leaf is used by the traditional healer for anti-hematic and antiseptic and digestive disorder. The fruit are consumed to cure the these disorder like the digestive disorder. Then Solanum aculeatensium, this is the bhindi, common name is bhindi, belongs to family same Solanaceae and found in the area Rodi village of the Palampur. The flowering season is May to October, and whole plant is used by the traditional healer for the various problems like the toothache and whooping cough. Then next plant is Solanum nigrum. It is very common. It is also found in the Delhi, belongs to family Solanaceae. The common name of this plant is Makoi. The location is Leher Behra village of Palampur. The flowering season is March to October, and part use is root. Or we can say the root is utilized by the traditional healer for curing the fever and diarrhea. They give the decoction to the patient for curing this disease. The fresh leaves are also used by the traditional healer for curing the jaundice. It is also used for the headache. The fresh leaves and the fruit paste is applied on the head to cure the headache. Even I came to know this is also used by the traditional healer for the swelling. They use the vegetable, means like a vegetable, make the sabji and eat it, even apply on the paste on the swelling part of the body. It really helpful. Then Solanum Vignium, it is known as Katili, belongs to the same family Solanaceae, and found in the same area like the Badrol village, and the flowering season is April to August, and the part used is dry seed and leaves. Traditional healer use this dry seed and leaves to cure the asthmatic patient and to cure the cough. Dry seed and the leaves are crushed and burn on the coal. It smoke is inhaled by the patient for curing the asthmatic problem. This particular plant is also used for curing the liver problem and fever. The dry seed and the leaves are boiled in a hot water and used by the traditional healer for curing the liver problem. Then Helicteris isora, it is commonly known as the marodhari. As the name indicate, marodhari means if you have the some kind of the ethan or marod in the stomach, the traditional healer use the fruit of this particular plant. Even the flower, root and stem is also utilized by the traditional healer for the dysentery and stomach. The fruit are consumed and boiled with the sugar, and the decoction is used to cure the dysentery and the stomach. Even if you see in the rural area, you will find it out, the people are use this marodhari for the kettles also. The Vidhania somnifera, the commonly name is ashwagandha. We all are aware with this fact that the ashwagandha is a very good immune booster, because nowadays in the pandemic everybody has taken the ashwagandha powder, ashwagandha tablet to improve their immunity. And it is also belongs to the family Solanaceae and found in the Badrol village of the Palampur. The flowering season is June to November, and the part use is flower. The ethnobotanical uses of this particular plant is constipation, arthritis and others also. As I told you, it is a very good immune booster. Camellia sinensis, it's a very common. We generally, the Indian people use this chai daily in the morning. Belongs to the family Thiaceae and found in the village Kandi of Palampur. The flowering season is September to November, and the part used by the traditional healer is leaves, and it is a very good stimulant and used by the traditional healer for other disease also. Then Bohinia, it's a handa, common name is handa, and found in the same area, and the flowering season is June to September, and the part uses fresh leaves. The traditional healer use the fresh leaves for the oral hygiene. The fresh leaves are crushed and a paste is used for treatment of the oral diseases. The next plant is Utrica dioica, commonly known as bichu booty. It is belongs to family Utricaceae and found in the Rodi village of Palampur, and their flowering season is June to October, and stem is utilized by the traditional healer for curing the boils. Root is grinded with the kalimirch, and seed of this kalimirch in cow urine, and they use to cure the boils. Even the fresh branches having the stings are touched to the itching and swollen part of the body. And I would like to share the one thing in the bichu booty. If you are going to the hill area, if you touch this plant, you must have some very itching problem in the any body touch with this plant, but nature is very, very kind. The antidote of this plant is also available near to this plant, means as I told you, the Rumex in the earlier slide. Rumex is known as jangli palak, which is available near to this plant. You just take the leaf of this Rumex and crush it and apply on the area where this plant is touched. You after a 2 minute you will get the relief. The next plant is Lantana camara. Lantana camara belongs to family Verbenaceae and found in the same area, Rodi village of Palampur. Then flowering season is July to October. The part used by the traditional healer is whole plant, and they use this particular plant in influenza and cough, even in the pulmonary problem. Viola canescens, the belongs to family Violaceae and found in the same area. The flowering season is April to May. The flower and leaves are utilized by traditional healer of the area for curing the cough, cold and fever. The dry flower and the leaves are boiled in water, and decoction is given to the patient in the fever, and also 2-3 seeds of kali mirch is added while they are boiling the leaves of this particular plant for curing the various disease. Next plant is aloe vera. Aloe vera is a very, very common plant. It's commonly known by the traditional healers Guarpatta. Then it is also found in Badrol village of Palampur. The flowering season of this plant is March to July, and as you aware, it's a succulent plant, and the gel is there in the leaves of this plant. This leaves are utilized by the traditional healer for skin disease and a cut and insect bite also. The leaves pulp is used for treatment of various disease by the traditional healer. The leaf pulp is applied externally to the cut and insect biting also. Then curcuma longa. Curcuma longa is also a very, very common plant. It is commonly known as the haldi, as we all are aware with the fact that in Ayurveda it's written that it's a very good antiseptic, belongs to the family Gingivoraceae, found in the area Badrol of Palampur. The flowering season is September to October, and rhizome is utilized by the traditional healer for curing the wound healing. And the boiling with the mustard oil and used topically for the wound healing. Then gingiber officinalis, it is also a very common plant. So we all are used this adrak, commonly known as adrak, in daily life. We make the put the adrak in the chai, preparation of the tea. Then we use to put the adrak in the daily vegetables. Belongs to family Gingivoraceae and found in the area Badrol village of Palampur. The flowering season is September to December. The part uses rhizome, and the rhizome used by the traditional healer for cough and cold. And this roasted rhizome chewed and its juice mixed with honey to cure the cough and cold respectively. Even in our common home, we use the juice of this adrak with the honey to cure the cough. Next is the curcuma gidoria. This is also belongs to family Gingivoraceae, and the location is the same, means the Rodi village of Palampur. The flowering season is July to October, and rhizome is utilized by the traditional healer for curing the anti-tumor effect. Dry rhizome is crushed to powder, and its decoction is used to control the tumor. So we have discussed so many plants in the area. The conclusion of this ethnobotanical survey of the Palampur is here. We have conducted the survey with the help of the so many traditional healer and the local informant of the area. We collected 36 herb species from the plant, followed by the shrubs, 33 shrubs species, 21 trees, 10 climbers, 1 epiphytes, in descending order. The most dominant families, as we have discussed in these two, three lecture series on the ethnobotany, the Fabaceae, the Lamiaceae, the Asteraceae, the Moraceae, the Apocynaceae, and Euphorbiaceae. These are the dominating family over the area. The maximum number of the plant species were used to cure the gastrointestinal disorder, the skin disorder, the skeletal muscular disorder, the respiratory disorder, and the herb are most frequent and easy to assess and use for treatment of more than one disease in comparison to the shrubs and trees. Leaves were the most frequently used plant part to the treatment of disease, followed by the whole plant and other part of the plant. The traditional healer tends to prepare the medicine by combination of different plant species for curing the various disease. So, you all are aware with the fact that if we are making the or using the more than two plants to make the to cure the disease, that is also known as the polyherbal formulation. Then single plant is used for more than one disease treatment also. The combination of multiple herb in the ratio would given the better result than the single herbs, as we have discussed. We take the latex of the particular plant with the batasa, that is sugar. We take the certain things with the honey. So, it is more effective than taking the single herbs. The various methods were used for the preparation of the medicine. Indigenous medicine ingredient such as the paste, fresh plant part, juice, decoction, fresh and dry plant part, powder, etcetera, etcetera. In the last, I would like to say that we have to use the plant for curing the various disease. We are the ourselves the doctor, or the we can say that we can cure in a better way to utilizing the herbs for curing the various disease. I would like to acknowledge my student Atul Arya, who has conducted this survey in the Palampur area. Thank you so much. We'll continue this series in the next lecture.